Good morning, everybody. In previous classes, we have seen that the various aspects related to minor with whom we cannot enter into contract. Along with that, we also saw the various points or the people who are competent to enter into contract and the people with whom we cannot enter into contract. While seeing all these things, we need to understand that in that definition, we saw that a person with sound mind was there. Okay. Sound mind means what? The person, now section 12 of Indian Contract Act states the meaning of sound mind. What exactly sound mind means? A person is said to be of sound mind for the purpose of making a contract if at the time when he makes it, he is capable of understanding it and of forming a rational judgment as to its effects on his interests. Now, as per section 12 of Indian Contract Act, this is the definition of sound mind, which means a person who is said to be sound mind while entering into a contract or at the time of making the contract, he should be in a capacity of understanding it. It means what exactly he is doing, with whom he is entering into contract, for what he is entering into contract, what are the terms and conditions of the contract, everything he should be in a capacity to understand. If he is in a capacity to understand these things, or he is of forming, or he is able of thinking rationally, or make a rational judgment of whatever discussions he is in with, is said to be a sound mind person. Now, in simple terms, sound mind person is one who is capable of understanding and forming of rational judgment while entering into a contract. Now, any person who is having or who is capable of thinking or who is capable of understanding what contract he is making, with whom he is making the contract, and who is able to understand what are the pros and cons of that contract, or what are the things he is supposed to do, or the liable things and all, if he is able of thinking, understanding while entering into a contract and making rational judgments, is said to be of sound mind. But in case if a person is not able to understand, not able to make a rational judgment, at that point of time he is said to be unsound person. Now, with such an unsound person, we cannot enter into a contract, because the law will not permit us to enter into contract with such people. Now, who are those people, or people whom we can call as unsound, are here. While calling the people unsound, in that, the first person we have is lunatics. Lunatics means what? It is a state of mind, or it is a state of mind, or it is a disease in which a lunatic is a person who is mentally, what we call as, who is mentally ill, or who is of because of some mental strain. Sometimes he is conscious, sometimes he is unconscious, or sometimes he is capable of understanding the things, sometimes he is not capable of understanding the things. These things may happen due to strain, due to some mental illness, or what we call it as, he may suffer some intervals of sanity and insanity. Sanity means shuddhivarasne, insanity means shuddhivarnasne. So, a person who is in intervals of sanity and insanity, at that point of time, we cannot enter into a contract with such a person, because he is, whenever he is understandable, or we can enter only in contract with him when he is sane, or who is able to understand. म्हणजे शुद्धीवर असतेवर एवढंच आम्ही अशा व्यक्तींशी कॉन्ट्रॅक्ट करू शकतो. सो लुनॅटिक इज वन पर्सन, ऑर अ पर्सन हू इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम डिझीज ऑफ द ब्रेन, बिकॉज ऑफ विच समटाइम ही इज सॅनिटी, ही इज इन सॅनिटी, अँड समटाइम्स ही इज इन insanity. So we cannot enter into a person with a we cannot enter into a contract with a lunatic when he is insanity. After that we have idiots. Now many a times we use this words, especially girls use this word idiot. What do this idiot means actually? Many a times we use this word while speaking, while fighting, while quarrel and all, but we don't know the exact meaning of this word. Idiots means an idiot is a person who has lost his memory power. The person who has lost the memory power permanently, who cannot recall anything permanently, his memory power is lost. Therefore, he is permanently incapable of entering into contract. We cannot enter into a contract with this kind of person who is idiot. Or idiot means what? The person who has permanently lost his memory. Okay, this kind of person is called as idiot. At the end, we cannot enter into contract with such a person anytime. We cannot enter in contract with such kind of people. Now this term idiot we use oftenly, but exactly it means that the loss of memory permanently because of age factors, because of some injury to brain, there are many such factors because of which one person can lose his memory permanently. So here this is a person with whom we cannot enter into a contract. After that, drunken or intoxicated persons. Now, drunken or intoxicated persons are those who are taking intake of intoxicated products, or who is drunk of wine and all so much that he is not in a condition to understand what he is speaking, what he is making, or what move he is making. He is not able to understand. He is not able to make a rational judgment at any point of time. When he is intoxicated or when he is drunken, he or she may not be able to understand or may not be able to make a rational judgment. So at that point of time, we cannot enter into contract with such a person. So we cannot enter into a contract with drunken or intoxicated person when he or she is not in a position to make rational judgment. Okay, when they are not in a capacity to make rational judgment, at that point of time we cannot enter into a contract with such a person. So therefore this kind of contract is a void contract. And if a person is in a normal situation, at that point of time, if he is capable of making rational decisions or rational judgments, at that point of time we can enter into a contract with any person. After that we have hypnotized persons. Now hypnotized means it is a temporary situation wherein one person is made to go or who has been hypnotized, and he or she is not able to make rational decisions or he may not be able of thinking what he is doing, or he may not have control of over his brain. So therefore, at such a situation, we cannot enter into a contract with a person who is hypnotized. Okay, during the hypnotized period, we cannot enter into a contract with the person. So therefore, the person who has been hypnotized, we cannot enter into a contract with such a person. Now after that we have mentally decayed person. Now mentally decayed persons are those persons who are aged, who are like having due to age factor or old age, the mentally decayed process happens and he or she may not be able of making the rational judgments. So at that point of time we cannot enter into a contract with such people or such person. So therefore, the person who is mentally decayed, we cannot enter into contract with such persons. Now, in case if we are entering into a contract with such person, what happens? Now, when we are entering into contract with such people or such person, at that point of time, whenever an agreement entered into a person of an unsound mind is absolutely void. Absolutely, this kind of contract is inoperative. We cannot enter into such contract. Even though if we enter into contracts, it is inoperative, it is void, and void against him. But he can derive benefits under it. If he is supposed to get the basic necessities and all out of that property, he is of he should be given all the basic necessities which are required for him. So we should remember that unsound person is a person who is said to be sound person is said to be of sound mind for the purpose of making a contract. At a time when he is making a contract, he should be able to understand, he should be able to make a rational decision. If a person is able to make a rational decision, we can say that he is a sound person. And unsound person are those in that we saw lunatics, idiots, drunken or intoxicated person, hypnotized person and mentally decayed person. So in that first one was lunatics. Lunatics, it is a disease of brain in which he is in the intervals of sanity and insanity. After that we had idiot. Idiot is a person who has lost his memory permanently. And after that, drunken or intoxicated person who takes more intake of intoxicated products or who drinks more. After that we have hypnotized person. Hypnotized person is a person who is temporarily put in a situation wherein he cannot make any rational judgment or rational thinking. After that there is a person, mentally decayed person. This happens because of old age and all. So we cannot enter into contract with these people. So in this video, this much. Let's stop here. If you all have any doubts, queries, you can contact me. Thank you. Good day.